Now the substitution coming up for Canada.
I mean, during a game, it's pretty intense, so it's not like, hey, you're going to go in. It's mostly like, is Jordyn ready? Like, that's generally what happens.
But we got a look at this young lady briefly wearing the number 23, 16 years of age. This is Jordyn Huitema.
Bright future for Canada.
And there you look at the future of the game.
I mean, obviously it means a lot. Like, it's my first goal. It wasn't the greatest goal I've ever scored.
Fleming, and back, little give, little go. Fleming lays it on through. Here, Lawrence cuts it back. And finally, it's in.
It was a little tap in, but no, every goal counts. And I mean, I'm so grateful that I was able to share that opportunity with the women around me. And yeah, I wouldn't have gotten that opportunity if they wouldn't have put the ball perfectly on the line for me to just get a little knee.
The second one was a bit nicer though, right?
Yeah, that was a bit better.
Huitema who put it behind for goal number five, goal number six. Hello and welcome, Jordyn Huitema.
Well, she's making a name for herself. Hello, Toronto. My name is Jordyn Huitema.
I felt the first one, she didn't really want to claim it, you could see. It was an ugly goal. She didn't really know she'd scored. And I almost feel like she had the bit between her teeth to go and score a proper goal. And I think she did. I mean, that's the gift that she has. I think this woman can score goals.
It's been my dream since I was little to not just play alongside them, but to help them win and help them score goals. And so, no, it was just kind of like my dream come true. Oh, jeez. Riggs, I followed you and you did it wrong. Soccer was more of like a fun sport for me until like 13, I'd say. It was more for enjoyment, and it was never serious to me. Like, well, it was serious, but like not like, this is my route and this is what I'm gonna do with it. So no, I was just having fun and like living my life. And then when I got to like age 13, 14, it started to become more serious. And I started to love it more, and you know, I thought like, this is what I want to do in the future. I think it was the 2012 Olympics. Like, that was definitely a huge moment for Canada.
Fellinio being the highest striker. No, it's a Ted Crady. Opportunity here, Christine Sinclair. One-on-one, Sinclair scores! Sinclair's in the penalty area. Pass towards Christine Sinclair!
You know, the 2012 was definitely like a kind of a switching point for me to like start loving soccer and say, hey, like one day I want to be on the podium with that team. And I do think that that will be in our near future. Am I going? You going?
I mean, it's been crucial to our success. I think the Whitecaps came on a journey with us back in 2014. They were one of the first to step forward and say, we're going to help you build this regional Excel program. Since then, they've become a super center where, you know, kids from around Canada come to the Whitecaps. There's great leadership there with, you know, Emma Humphreys, who's, you know, a woman leading women, which I think is crucial. And when you look at what Jordyn is accessing now, it's a daily training environment with best in Canada.
I mean, Jordan's an amazing kid. She's really, really good character to have out there in the group. She has had amazing performances on the field, but also she's the hardest working in the training ground, but also in the classroom. She sets a really good example, especially for such a young kid.
She's super funny, energetic, like she's always the life of the party, cracking jokes.
If anybody wants to go camping this weekend, hit me up.
Hardest shot I've ever faced. Not just power, her accuracy is insane.
Even after a full day of school, you want to come out here and you want to play and you want to have fun with your friends and perform at the highest level. So
get out.
No, it's just a place to develop and grow, and
Jordyn,
it's amazing.
Yeah.
Ah.
we brought her into a training camp. She wasn't selected, but we brought her in as an additional player.
I looked to the right, and there's these little windows in the doors, and I could see Kadisha Buchanan, and someone else was standing behind the windows, and I got so scared. I went to the left, and I hid in this little room for another hour or so, and then I finally grew enough courage to go into the room with them.
Into the middle, Huitema. Huitema turns, Huitema, Huitema, and she'll go for goal herself.
When you ask what I seen, it was pace. You know, pace in the modern game is crucial if you're in the forward line. She has the height, very different to what we've got in our current squad. You know, she's approaching 6 foot. You know, she's probably going to be a bit taller than 6 foot, but combined, that height with pace is pretty unique. And then coupled to that, you know, her forward instincts are there. She's got genuine forward instincts, not stuff that you can teach either. So when you've seen these sort of things at 14, you were like, okay, we've got some potential gold on our hands here.
Every little girl's idol is Christine Sinclair. And I mean, when I was younger, she was my huge idol, and I never thought in a million years that I'd be playing alongside her. So no, she still is my idol. Every day at training, I look at her and think, wow.
I look back at seeing Sink as a player for the first time, coaching against her in New Zealand. You realize that she's a phenomenal athlete. You know, she has this imposing figure. You know, she's 5'10", 5'11". She was fast, good technique, great football brain. So she had all those things where you went complete package. Like, this is going to be tough. You know, some players only have one of those things. She has them all. And you looked at Jordyn and you went, you know what? She's got the pace. She's got the height. She's got the football brain. Yeah, I mean, this is as close to the full package as a striker that you've seen, like that sort of Ibrahimovic type, you know, build. So, you know, the one thing that she can't be cast with is being the next Sink, because no one will ever be Sink. Like what she's done for this country, what she's done for the women's game here, how she's, you know, stamped her authority on the women's game and her identity, no one else will do that in the way Sink.